here we are on Paragon with Dre and Mo. Hello. So it's just to prove the internet is real. And look, here's Jilly B.
Thank you for...
And we're having dinner on Paragon. How fantastic is that?
Thank you so much for telling us about Scalaway. You're the
don't tell everybody about Scalaway, Drake. Don't, no, no, don't come to Scalaway.
It's terrible.
Just need the water to fill. Ah, wind turbine.
Have a bonus pig.
Huh?
Have you seen our bonus pig?
It's coming so handy, this bag. Just really realised last night as well, we don't have a yellow queue flag. So we might have to fly the bonus pig.
Really? That's great.
They're going to use their yellow bonus supermarket bag as a queue flag.
Awesome.
I wonder if this wind is going to be an issue for them. I would rather have it in the other direction.
Yeah.
Or actually, yeah, for going bow out, for us, it's a good direction.
Mm-hmm.
But for them, I think it makes it a little more complicated because it's blowing them.
I wonder if it would have been better to move last night to the T-Dock when it was calm.
Yeah.
I
think I heard the water tank bang.
Oh yeah!
Yeah, we don't like those noises very much. We try and catch it before the last really loud bang.
Really?
When the dog is here, he's really hypersensitive to those noises.
Really?
So he really goes, ah, the water's full, and starts barking.
That's how you know it's full.
Yes. So when he's not here, it's like, oh.
Did you sleep well?
No, not really.
Yeah.
I never do before. Yeah. I don't know about you, I always have the sort of dry mouth anxiety in the morning as well.
Oh yes, please. Girl, I'll grab that.
Thank you. I won't fling it down in case it catches you.
Oh, careful. It's going to tip you. Thank you. Well, it's rare having help.
Yeah.
They have an amazing boat.
Yeah.
I really like Tespes. I'm a little envious in some ways.
Why are you doing tiny coils?
Am I?
Yeah. It's fine.
It's fine, but it's just got so much more interior space. It's unbelievable.
Yeah.
For the same length. Yeah, I know.
And then when I shove, so as we go forward, as soon as it's clear that angle, I'll say snub it. You snub that, and then the boat should swing round on that spring.
Okay.
And then once we're round, then just head out and you chuck it off, and Drake's going to grab it, and Drake will coil it up.
Okay.
Once we're away.
Yay! Happy with that?
Yep.
Well, I think that's us then.
Okay.
Power's off. Water's filled. Halyard's back. Sails are ready.
Sheets are on.
Anything else?
It might be.
We better go.
We'll find out soon enough.
Yes.
Right, you ready, Jill?
you. And you too.
Thank you.
I hope you have a really good journey across the North Sea.
Line?
Sorry?
Are you ready on that
yes.
line?
Yes.
Then pull us as far that way as you can.
So we left Scalloway this morning and our auto helm failed, so we stopped at Papastua and tied up there for a little while I fixed it, and while we were there the sun came out, the wind died and the sea calmed down, and now we've got a beautiful sail heading up the west side of Shetland. There's the cliffs of Esherness in the distance. There's Gilly enjoying the sun with her woolly hat on. And there's Papastua disappearing at the background. It's 3 in the morning. This is me going on my second watch. That's where we are. That's where we're going. Hello, honey. Have you had a good watch?
I have. I feel like a narcoleptic.
Oh, it was nice up here when I left you.
There has been a little bit of moistness.
Okay, I'll take it from here. Thank you.
Stay on board.
Okay. See you in 3 hours. Well, it's 3 a.m. So what we got? There's no engine. Winds on the starboard quarter, 12 knots. We're doing five and a half knots, and we're 6 knots, and we're dead on course. It's the weather and the sea. It's nice over there. And that's Shetland in that direction. That's where the rain seems to be coming from at the minute. Have a look at the sails. All the attention has slipped on the main. And the jib looks okay. Nice morning. Sometimes it's a real pleasure getting up at 3, coming and doing a watch on a day like today. Some seabirds flying about. Looks like there might be a little bit of sun coming when it comes up. And test best is just flying along very nicely. 6.5, 7 knots. What an absolute pleasure. Another watch over, doing my log.
What?
I'm talking to myself in the camera. That's the next watch coming on. Hello, next watch. And plot a position on the chart. This is the chart pencil. Drive that across. Which puts us there. At 0600. There's not much going on out here. There's just enough wind to keep us sailing. We've had to slightly head north a little bit to keep the sail filled. The wind's a little bit too far behind for comfort, but it's good enough. We're managing five plus knots. Toasted cheese and sausage sandwich with brown sauce. Yum yum. Best sandwich ever! Is our 1800. Jill?
Yeah.
Turn round.
Yeah.
Say something. Tell us a little story. What are you doing?
I'm not convinced that thing we've seen on deck is a oil rig, and I'm wondering if it is in fact some kind of naval ship.
So I'm going to have a look. It could be a naval ship that wouldn't have AIS.
No,
yeah.
It wouldn't. So I'm going to have a look because it looks
How are you going to look through them?
I'm going to look through that.
All right.
Although maybe raise them up a bit higher.
Okay. Definitely don't bang yourself in the eyes with them.
I will be careful.
And remember,
you.
I put the strap on.
Thank you.
Yeah, yeah. Safety first.
Thank you very much.
There he is. And yeah, he's some kind of naval vessel. So no AIS. Maybe he's making all the noise we've been hearing, all the whistling in the water. Maybe he's looking for Russian subs. We are approaching Lepsoy and Vigra on the path that Betty Mort would have come on the Columbine when she drifted onto the shores of Lepsoy. She was very lucky. It's not an easy passage, even when you know where you're going.
That's our cue flag.